Yellow icon is for the classical worksheet, and the red icon is for the Java version of that same thing. That is more popular, and if you are working on Mac, it doesn't allow classical worksheet. It is only in the window where you can have classical worksheet. Because most of the people have window now, so we should work in the classical worksheet, right? In window also, you can work in the Java environment because the output is very, very, very effective and it becomes a bit faster also. So, Maple 13 or Maple 15, similar calculation I can do in Mathematica also. I can do similar calculation in Mathematica using GIA tensor only, right? So, I am using GIA tensor, but there are many packages. And in the Maple, in Mathematica, it is called GR tensor M. So, same ability in Mathematica also. But I prefer Maple because output of Maple is very good. Distribute, you want to distribute? Right. So, output in Maple is very good. Mathematica output is not so good. So, what is my advice? Either dekho, either please. So, in symbolic calculation, always use GIA tensor, and for plotting or numerical calculation, use Mathematica, because that is what we do in most of the calculation. What I am trying to do is, I will work in GIA tensor 2, GIA tensor 2 within Maple, not GIA tensor 3, right? GIA tensor 3 is made for the Java version. And it works fine in Linux and also in the Mac, but it is not available in Windows. Windows is also being launched soon, it will also work. So, GIA tensor 3 is latest, but I will work with GIA tensor 2 only now. So, I will be working only in GIA tensor 2. GIA tensor 2, and it is freely available. Written by Kyle Lake and his team. So he is from Canada, and they also contribute to the creation of Maple. All the commands now are inbuilt in the Maple, but still it is difficult. This command which I am telling you, most of the commands can be done without GIA tensor also. But because GIA tensor is very free, most of our people use GIA tensor for all calculation, right? GIA tensor. Without GIA tensor, Maple has all ability, but like Ganuji showed you have to do some programming, big programming. This is only command base. There is nothing, no programming here. You can still do programming, but it is not required. You can write a code and generate write command in Maple, and you can generate Fortran code, and you can generate C code, right? Many people use Maple to generate their long codes of Fortran and C in this, because it is very easy to generate any code also. Code. Suppose I write integrate command and do calculation, entire thing can be converted into C code or in the Fortran code. So that's why it is very popular. Maple is most popular software for the mathematician, right? Now, I just want to tell you, because yesterday people said it was a bit fast, so I just want to go a bit slow. So, first I have to invoke in Maple 13. So, this will be my first command in most of the sheet. Before that, I will write restart. Right? You can give colon after restart, but most of the command is followed by semicolon. Right? The aim is to do what is done in the first lecture calculation, basic calculation. Once you know the basic calculation, you can build anything of your own. What is happening these days, we even derivative, if you are to do, we do with Maple only, we don't do by hand. Most of the calculation, so if you have any target, try to make a worksheet for that. and then you can do your own calculation, right? So make a worksheet, it is 100% error free. So it is better to use Maple for any kind of calculation. The first thing, how many of you know Schwarzschild black hole? So was it told today? The first thing I will tell you is how to derive Schwarzschild black hole. First thing, and then I'll move to other Robertson Walker and all, because that is the easiest. So this is your Schwarzschild solution. This is your Schwarzschild solution. It is spherically symmetric solution of what? RAB is equal to 0 or GAB is equal to 0. It is spherically symmetric solution of RAB is equal to 0 or GAB is equal to 0. It is one and same thing. When there is no matter, so your R becomes 0, and that is how you get. This is the solution. So I am going to derive this. This is a spherically symmetric black hole solution. So if you want to derive, you have to start with a general metric and then calculate the component and solve the field equation. So you should start with something like this. You should start with something like this, 1 by r, 1 by f of r, or you can have different function also. That will also can be taken care. So minus 1 by f of r dr square, then dr square plus r square d omega square. D omega square, you know what is d omega square. You can start with this and exactly calculate your Einstein equation, and then use the desolve facility and of the Maple, and then try to solve. So that is the first thing. That is the first thing I'm going to demonstrate as a Schwarzschild solution of right. So it is this one. Yeah, this is Birkhoff theorem. Right. So this is this. So first command, as I said, always I'll give restart. Always I'll give first command as restart. So that is restart, because if there is anything in the memory, it will be cleared. Right? And then I'm invoking GR tensor. Right? In Java mode, see, here many people last time asked that this doesn't work. So what you have to do? You have to start Maple first and then load the worksheet, otherwise it will not work. If you click a worksheet, it will open, but it will not work. That is the limitation here, but that problem is solved in the Java version. You can click worksheet and then it starts working. Here what you have to do, first you have to load Maple. So Maple initializes GR tensor, and then you can load any worksheet of the GR tensor, otherwise it will not work, right? So this is a ready-made worksheet, but we can make always. So this is a metric. I am using a signature. I am using two functions. You can see there is the AR and BR. You can also use same function. It's up to you, right? So this metric is already this. How to create this metric? That is clear to everybody. In Maple, how to create this metric? That is, yesterday I told you, you can use make g command. If you make g command, and then you can create this metric, right? This metric was created before, so I'll just directly load. If anybody is not familiar with GR tensor, he can create this. So it is loading. All right. This is slower. If you see, yesterday Maple was very fast, so this is a bit slower. So it has a coordinate r theta phi t. You can use t r theta phi also, because this was entered like r theta phi t. So it is working like this. You can use t r theta phi. With most of the convention is what? T r theta phi. People use this. But it may not be there. It may not be in your because this metric is stored. If it is not there, I'll tell you how to calculate this. it is very simple to calculate. If it is not there, just write here make g. Make g x, y, z. I am creating x, y, z. Right? So, it will create your metric. Then you write 2 because I want to enter line element. See, make g x, y, z. So, it will ask for line element or whatever you want to enter. I will not enter basis. I will enter line element. So, that is why I am giving 2. So, I just give 2. Then I give coordinate tr theta phi, and then it will create easily metric, right? Tr theta phi, control V, and then it is there, and then it asks for metric, and then you supply the metric, it will be done, right? So, let me do the same way, because I wrote Tr theta phi, it will be like this, so it is Br. So, I will enter the metric here, minus Br. Br hai nahi ye wala br dekh lijiye idhar it is br here so I want to create same matrix so that you don't have any problem br star d t whole power 2
here t is first
so you are writing first thing because my t is for no doesn't matter you can write anyway it will be okay it will be okay I mean it is fine but I am writing exactly same so a of r You can write any way you like. Star D square. Kya ho gaya? Nahi zarurat hai. Where it is? Square bracket. Not. Nahi bracket square bracket kahan pe? Nahi kahi.
Nahi.
Bas D derivative wale. One. So that's how it will be created. Nahi hai to create ho jayega static. So it is correct. All correct. This question is asked whether you have complex, no complex, and that's it. It is one. It is there. So it is created. You can see it is created. Same it. Right. All right. Is it clear to you? सेव हो जाएगा मैट्रिक देखिए वो सेव कहाँ पे होगा देखिए आई विल टेल यू वेयर इट विल बी सेव इन दिस डायरेक्टरी दैट पाथ हैज टू बी गिवन देयर इट विल बी सेव्ड इन दैट GRT6 मैट्रिक्स हाँ ऑल मैट्रिक्स विल बी सेव्ड देयर मैट्रिक्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सो इट विल बिकॉज फिर और कहीं नहीं होगा इट विल बी सेव्ड देयर ओनली इफ यू वॉन्ट आई कैन शो यू हाउ टू लोड दैट जस्ट नाउ आई कैलकुलेटेड X, Y, Z, that also I can show you. It is there now. So, it is there. You can load anything you like. Right? Once it is made, it will not give error. Before, if I say X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z, A, B, C, it will give error. Because it is not there. It will give error. Correct? So, it will give error because there is no metric. But X, Y, Z, if it is there, it will not give any problem. It will give error. नहीं मैंने है ना नाम तो एक ही रहता है ना एनी फाइल हैज ओनली सिंगल नेम तो वो कैसे और दूसरा चूज करेंगे आप बोल रहे हैं ना यू आर सेइंग दैट क्यू लोड एक्स वाई जेड तो इट विल लोड एक्स वाई जेड नेम ऑफ द मैट्रिक मैट्रिक नेम एक्स वाई जेड आपकी जो मर्जी दे दे वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू गिव नेम इट इज फाइन इट्स अप टू यू राइट सो इफ द मैट्रिक एग्जिस्ट इन द डायरेक्टरी इट विल लोड अदरवाइज इट विल नॉट लोड इज दैट क्लियर So again, most of the time, because now see there are two metric in the memory. I have loaded XYZ, I have loaded statica. So it creates confusion sometime. But you can work with two metric. You can work with two metric. But very rarely you need a two metric. Right? So I'll advise you to always work with one metric. So I am again restarting and I will only load statica. So I told you how to make a metric. Online exactly and then I'm again going back this. So as I said there, it is solution of Einstein equation. There is no matter black hole, there is the right hand side is absent. So you need only left hand side, GAB, right? So you need to calculate what is your GAB. So I am calculating here GAB, you see. GAB, you can calculate up down, you can calculate down down, because right hand side is 0, there is no problem. You see GR calc G down down, and I am also displaying it, right. So, this is what is the calculation. All right. So, there are how many equations? There are actually here, because it is spherically symmetric, actually it reduces to 4 equations. But basically, there are only 2 independent equations, the T equation and one R equation, all equations are same. So, I can solve one of the equation, either TT equation, or I can solve RR equation and get with the solution. So, what I am trying to do is also adding lambda. So, what I will do? I will add also lambda. GAB plus lambda GAB is equal to 0. So, I am using cosmological constant also. So, that equation I am trying to solve. All right. So, you see this next command is very important. Okay. Here, any doubt?
Yeah. Suppose I want to create a mixed form.
What mixed form?
Mixed form is up, O and contrast, G, A, up, G and G.
Up, down, to up, down, likh dijiye. यहीं पे अप डाउन यहाँ पे अप डाउन यहाँ पे अप डाउन लिख दीजिए राइट इफ यू कैलकुलेट अप डाउन इट विल गिव अप डाउन एंड कैलकुलेशन में जी आर सॉरी नॉट हियर हियर जी आर कैल्क वेयर आई सेड कैल्क हियर इट शुड बी अप डाउन इंडेक्स इज अप डाउन बिकॉज ये राइट हैंड साइड जीरो अप डाउन लिखो डाउन डाउन लिखो एनीथिंग इज या नाउ आई एम टेलिंग यू Even if you write up, down, down, it is not a problem, right? So, I got this equation. Now, you see, first equation, if you see first equation, that is the first equation, I am trying to recall. So, before, if you see this here, this equation, so there are 4 equations, one is TT equation, one is RR equation, one is theta, theta, phi, phi. So, I am taking TET equation. So, we will GTT plus lambda GTT will solve equal to 0. So, that is what I am trying to do here. So, this is your G down down, same equation there, plus lambda G small g is a metric is equal to 0, and that becomes a differential equation, and you can solve that for function AR. First equation you can solve for a function AR, right? Because this is the equation, your TT equation, BR is not there, only AR is there. So, that can be solved for A. So, it will take some time here, because there are a lot of things. So, that's the solution, right? Integration of constant, you can take mass of the black hole. If you have done, it must have been told, you can choose C1 is equal to minus 2m, and then it becomes like this. So, here I am putting integration constant, which is my choice. I can choose minus 2m, and that will be the black hole talk. I can give some depth why we are choosing minus 2m and all. That will be separate talk. But here I am trying to tell you how. So, C1 I will choose as 2m. So, I am directly putting here. Here I am directly putting C1 is equal to minus 2m, and that is what is get. Right? So, now AR is known. So, once AR is known, it will be automatically substituted whenever you do the next calculation. So, wherever this GR tensor comes across AR, it will substitute the value. You do not have to worry, it will automatically substitute, because here I have assigned it. It will not do normally, but here I have assigned. When you write semicolon equal to, then in the memory you have AR is equal to this, right? Now, I need to calculate the other one. Other thing, so that will be calculated, BR. I want to calculate BR, second solution, right? So, AR is there, it will be automatically substituted in rest of the equation. If I invoke any of those equations, it will be there. So, like this. So, you got BR also, because AR was substituted. If you take RR equation has both A and B. RR equation has both A and B, but it was substituted, right? It was substituted, and that is how you got this. So, this is your BR, right? And now I can display metric. So, you will see that this is there. BR was not assigned, but BR is here. I can, what I can do, I can write here BR, so it will be there. All right? Is it clear here? Any doubt? See, BR is here. I have BR is here, so it will become like. So that's solution. So when you put lambda is equal to 0, it will become that solution. Is it clear? Any doubt? Now my one simple question. What is my simple question is this. Suppose now I give the command gr calc g up down. What will be the answer? Can you say, tell me? What will be the answer? GR calc. If I put this now, what will be my answer? Can you tell me?
Zero.
What will be the answer? Zero is the wrong answer. Any other answer? Zero is not correct answer. Huh? नहीं वो ठीक है वो तो मैं ठीक कर रहा हूँ मैंने आपको एक बार बता दिया लेट अदर आंसर दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट आंसर व्हेन यू से नॉन जीरो सो एनी अदर आंसर अरे लैम्बडा हो जाएंगे वरना लैम्बडा भी व्हाट लैम्बडा क्या लैम्बडा बताइए कैसे सिर्फ लैम्बडा बोल दे लैम्बडा नहीं राइट सो सी व्हाट इज द लॉजिक नाउ वी हैव ए सोल्यूशन सोल्यूशन ऑफ आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन Right? Solution, second Einstein equation, GAB plus lambda A, GAB is equal to 0 in the memory. So, if I again calculate that, it should in principle become 0. But I am not calculating GAB plus lambda GAB. I am calculating the upper one. So, that lambda part will be left out. Other thing will be there. So, let me calculate this. GR calculate. This is calculated and GR display. So that will be calculated, right? Because I didn't calculate that lambda part. So if I want to calculate the, I want to get 0, I must have here lambda plus lambda GAB, right? So I didn't calculate that, I calculated GAB. So this is only lambda left, up down, isle only minus. If I calculate down, there will be something else, right? So that is the first solution. Any doubt? कोई डाउट है तो पूछ लीजिए देन आई विल प्रोसीड फॉर द नेक्स्ट वन एनी डाउट यू नो व्हाट इज बरकफ थ्योरम बरकफ थ्योरम किसको नहीं मालूम है एनीबडी नोज बरकफ थ्योरम क्या है बरकफ थ्योरम हाँ तो व्हाट इट सेज दैट एक्सटीरियर ऑफ एनीथिंग Any spherical symmetric object, if you take anything, the exterior must be Schwarzschild. Exterior of any star is a Schwarzschild, right? This is called Birkhoff theorem. It's a very famous theorem, and there was hundreds of paper came in the Birkhoff theorem name. So actually, we can prove that exterior of any spherically symmetric matrix, this is the exterior solution when right hand side is zero. Now what happens here, I started with a particular matrix. Let me start with any matrix. If you start with any matrix and you solve this GAB is equal to 0, you must come at this only, this solution only. That is what is the Birkhoff theorem says. So I want to prove Birkhoff theorem. It was a very famous theorem and many paper came on that and I want to take that. That is very, very famous theorem on the Birkhoff theorem. So it requires partial differential equation, solving partial differential equation because I am taking very general thing, very, very general thing. So it requires partial differential equation. Sometime it will not be able to solve partial differential equation or ordinary differential equation. Then you need to invoke tools, PDE tools and ODE tools, there are tools. So it comes with practice, it will automatically. So I'll again restart and then I have loaded the partial. Right? So, one minute, it's correct here, that's right. So, now what I am trying to do, I am taking a very general matrix, before I took a particular. Now you see here I am taking f and h to be any function. The previous case what I said, it is a function of r only and I got Schwarzschild solution. But I am trying to show that you take any function, if you solve vacuum equation, it will be a Schwarzschild solution. That what is the meaning, exterior. So, general function f of tr, that is why you will generate partial differential equation. Because now there is no one variable, there are two variables, t and r. So, it will generate partial differential equation. So, I am taking very most general equation. But now you know how to generate MG, so I am not doing that. So, this is general metric and it is saved. Calculate this, so it becomes very horribly compact, complicated equation. Right. Now, this is a very complicated equation and it is need to be solved. So, I have given you system of equation, because this is not one equation, it is system of equation because there are two variables, right. So, I am taking a system of equation. So, TT equation, I have taken all equation, TT equation, RT equation, RR equation, theta theta equation. Because phi phi equation is not independent. So, I do not have to take phi phi equation. You have off diagonal equation also. So, I have taken, normally you will have TT equation, RR equation, theta theta equation, phi phi equation. Here you have RT equation also. Understand properly. Here you have TT equation, RR equation, RT equation, theta theta equation, all these are independent equation. In case of spherically static, spherically symmetric, symmetric only two independent equation, but here there are four independent equation because only theta theta and phi phi is same. Only theta theta and phi phi is same. So, I have separately considered all equations, system of equation. So, I have this TT equation, RRT equation, RR equation, theta theta equation, and then I try to solve them. So, it gives me solution. And you see this FTR is first equation and the second equation is this. Again, I can put C1 is equal to 2m and then you get this. All right. And this is what is the metric. This is what is the metric. All right. One, sir? Wo constant that can be absorbed actually properly. That can be absorbed appropriately, right. But basically it is a Schwarzschild solution. I think ye jo isme hai na, isme slightly error, ye ft, f1t should come with dt. F1t should come with dt and then it will be absorbed. It will be absorbed very easily, right.
Ye r
kya to usko divide kar dijiye. No, no, कहीं confusion, कहीं क्रिया प्रॉब्लम, no, 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 कहीं mistake हो गया इसमें, one minute, कहीं typing है, हाँ, नहीं, 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 नहीं,
हाँ,
सब, substitution में कुछ error हो गए, हाँ, इधर error हो गए, up to this is fine, don't worry about this, yeah, ये छोड़ दीजिए, ये गलत है, because you can see this f is correct,
हाँ,
ये substitution में, ये step गलत है, इसको मैं हटा देता. Otherwise, everything is fine. I'll tell you, I'll write here, there. Okay? This is very simple.
Sir, ye substitution
ka main bata de raha hu, ek minute mein bata raha. So, what you are getting is minus 1 by 1 minus 2m by r and f1t is getting extra dt square. So, but this can be redefined. Time can be redefined. Bas khatam baat. New time aa jayega. Theek hai na? So, that is not a problem. Ye maine substitution mein ulta kar diya tha. That's why it was giving wrong. But this is correct metric. This is a, this you can see, you don't worry about this. This is, this has to be interchanged. So, this comes with f. So, if f your first function, h your second function. So, this will be redefined by time. Wo to malum hai na sabko, how to redefine time. Is it clear na? Redefining time, theek hai na? F1, you can write f1 dt as root f1 t dt as another time. So, that will become T. So, that will be absorbed. Huh? Kya ho gaya? अरे भाई स्टैटिक के तो हु सेड नो हो जाएगा, यू फिर देन यू डोंट डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड प्रॉपरली व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू डू इज ए बरकफ थ्योरम. वेर इज आई स्टार्टेड नॉट विथ स्टैटिक स्फेरिकल टाइम. अब तो देन यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग. Did I start with spherical symmetry, static space-time? I started with non-static space-time.
DT is there.
नहीं, RT है ना function है ना, दो variable है. I started with two variable function ना. तो very static. Is that clear? समझ में आ गया क्या? हाँ? Ultimately it is correct कि there is static के लिए वो constant हो गया. But here you get a solution. Where that you can redefine the time and then it's fine. It's fine. Is it any difficulty? Aur koi? Redefine time, redefine kar dete. Isko simple hai. You can define another time, tau, which is equal to root f1t, or you can write t square is equal to dt. Ye better hai, t is equal to, yeah. बस हो गया न्यू टाइम, बस खत्म बात. बस सब्स्टिट्यूट कर दो इसको इसमें, एक ही तो टर्म में टी है, एक ही टर्म में टी है ना, और कहीं तो टी नहीं है. यहाँ पे सब्स्टिट्यूट कर दीजिए, बस खत्म बात. मैटर एंड टॉ टॉइस टाइम, फिर टी लिख दीजिए उसको, उसको टी लिख दीजिए, कोई प्रॉब्लम ही नहीं है. यू राइट व्हाट यू लाइक, ठीक है ना. पहले टॉ से स्टार्ट कर दीजिए. You start with tau first and then write t. It doesn't matter. Whatever you want, you can do it. Any difficulty? Samajh mein aaya? Why you are laughing? What is your name? You understand or not? You understand or not? Yeah, it's okay. You use maple?
No.
You should use. It is where, from where you do?
No, sir.
From?
To
use karte nahi maple? No. Karna chahiye na? Kiske saath kaam kar rahe? अच्छा, यू शुड यूज मेपल एंड मैथमेटिका वेरी इफेक्टिवली. सो इट्स वेरी लॉट, देर आर पीपल हु कम्स हियर फॉर प्रोजेक्ट आई आई टी कानपुर. सो दैट्स वेरी इजी. एनी डिफिकल्टी? तो वट इज योर, लेट्स सी वट्स नेक्स्ट. आई वॉन्ट टू डू वन मोर, देन आई मूव टू रॉबर्टसन वॉकर. वी हैव टाइम, इज इट टाइम है ना अभी? हाँ ना, रॉबर्टसन वॉकर आई डू बिफोर. आई वॉन्ट टू डू वन मोर थिंग. आई वॉन्ट टू डू वन मोर थिंग. I want to transform a Schwarzschild matrix. Schwarzschild matrix किसने देखा? Who has not done Schwarzschild matrix yet? This is very important command. Many people doesn't work. Can't do this command. This is very very important. So it's a called, it's because in GR you make a frequent coordinate transformation. In any geometry you can do frequent coordinate transformation. Right. For example, Schwarzschild matrix has a singularity at r is equal to 2m. Is it there, singular? Singular hai ki r is equal to 2m pe? Because that diverges. The second term will diverge at r is equal to 2m. But if you make a coordinate transformation, that singularity will go. Right. If you go to Eddington coordinate, that singularity goes. So this is a coordinate singularity. It is not a serious singularity. So that's why it is very important. In the beginning people thought it's very important singularity. Later on it was proved that it is nothing but a coordinate singularity. So that's why coordinate transformation is very important, and it is difficult to do by hand sometimes. So let's try to understand how to. I will try to do this Eddington only first, then I'll do Kruskal. So transformation to Kruskal is there or not? Okay, let's do, then I'll do another coordinate, no problem. Same command. So let's start, restart lecture 1. So lecture 1 was my Schwarzschild solution, which I've derived. Right? F of R, same metric, same I've written. HR is 1 by R. So you can see, same I've written. What is in the blackboard? Blackboard it is written. Same thing. Right? So F of R means 1 minus 2m by R, HR is 1 over this, right? Now I want to remove this coordinate singularity R is equal to 2m, so that can be done by various coordinate. So I make a new coordinate like tau, t command. Yahan pe coordinate kya na change. Same way I can change r to r star. Now this, how this comes is very simple. It's not difficult, but this is not the aim of this course. It is very, very simple to make, find out this transformation. Very, very simple. You have to just integrate, right? So this is the new transformation. So what I'm doing in the original metric, we are changing r to r star, right? And then you have x form. This is what is the transform, x form. X form is a command which is very important, which makes new coordinate, right? So original coordinate is now RT is coming, changing to U and V, right? With this definition, this is the definition. Your R and T will become now U and V. Your theta remains unchanged. You can see theta is remaining theta only. Theta and phi is remaining phi only, although it is capital phi, but it doesn't make. So first I give the command x form, this is the coordinate, and then GR transform, you transform one coordinate to another coordinate. So lecture 1, which I said I created a Schwarzschild metric in r theta phi, r t r theta phi coordinate. Now I am converting into new coordinate u v theta phi, which is called Kruskal coordinate, right? So this, the command says transform the metric 1 to new metric through via this transformation. Is it clear? Command GR transform 1, GR transform 1 metric 1 to metric 3 say via this coordinate transformation. So this is very important transformation and it is very much required. So let me calculate this. So that is done. So now your new metric is GR tensor. See, it doesn't not only transform metric 1 to metric 3 or lecture 1 to lecture 3, that is my metric name. It also makes the new metric as a default metric. That is very important, very, very important. So that's how it gets. So it becomes a bit complicated, but I can simplify. As you say, simplify is very important thing. So you can simplify, you can trigonometric simplify, you can expand, you can power simplify. So very simple thing, simplify, previous calculation I simplify, I get simplification and then I display this. So this is what is the, still it is very complicated. This is very complicated. When I expand this, because exponential is there, it will become simple form, which is given in the textbook, right? So it is given in the textbook. This is the textbook. And further simplification will exactly give me. So some people, like Ganuji also told me yesterday, he doesn't like this GR tensor. Why? Because we are looking for this originally. We wanted this output, but the output original was very, very, very complicated. Looks like this. So he doesn't like. He said he doesn't like. And he also, he believes in his calculation. But this is also developed by very high expert. And I never found any error in this. So I believe this. But this simplification, you should know how to make simplification. So then you can get exactly output you need, looking for. So sometimes you have to do lot simplification. And finally it comes to exactly the form given in the textbook. You must have seen this Schwarzschild in Kruskal coordinate. In Kruskal coordinate. Is that clear? Simplify or simplify trigonometry, or you can write 1, there is a comma, instead of simplify you can write 1, 1 is simplified, 2 is trigonometric, 3, so there is a list. I mean you need to refer manual is there, so this is there, PDF files are there. I'll tell you Gauss-Bonnet calculation also if time gets. The complicated, very complicated. If you try to do by hand, it will be impossible. It becomes very long. So better do by this. Not only tensorial calculation or GR relativity calculation, you can do any calculation in the world using MAPLE, like finance or whatever. You are in any branch of science, but you can still use MAPLE. I'm telling even if you want to do image processing, you should do this. Image processing, you can do very good with maple, right? Because it has a very great ability of tackling mathematical symbol, right? Now let me go to your interest first, then I'll come to Gajbone. So you want that? What was your requirement? Robertson Walker. Okay. So let me go to Robertson Walker. So this, I'm not an expert in this. I'm a black hole man, so I hardly do this kind of calculation. So let's see. Okay, playing with GIAN tensor. So this is the website where it is available free. It is available free at this website, right? GIAN tensor, and you need maple. Maple we have given to everyone who required, and you can freely download this. So I will give one command before I move, because this is already there are so many things. Restart, because all those will be gone from the memory. So always try to give this, and then this, right? So this is the metric. First day he wrote this, isn't? Ye likha tha na, Robertson Walker. Yeah. So I'm trying to create this. First day it was written. I'm trying to this, and I will name it RW, RW1 or RW whatever. You can give me RW1 or you like what you gave name, right? RW1. So let's write. So the coordinate, what is the coordinate? I will of course enter the line element. Line element is option 2. Option 2 says line element, of course I'll enter line element. Right? So this is what is this 2 line element. What is coordinate here? XYZT. You can see XYZT or TXYZ, whatever coordinate. Right? So XYZT, you can give TXYZ, it's up to your choice. All right, so I have given this XYZT, and then you enter the metric. Entering is very easy. Aapko jyada fast to nahi lag raha na? Theek hai? So AT square DX, this is your all in the bracket, and then minus GT square. Robertson Walker, when K is equal to 0. I'm not taking K non-zero, so K I'm taking equal to 0. So very easy. And that's it. It is done. It is saved. Right? Is that clear? Very, very simple thing. Now let's do more calculation, which he did in the first lecture. what was the first thing? I will calculate now these objects. Right? Up, down, RAB up, all this calculation. Okay? So let's see this GR. GR display, so that is your metric. Metric inverted, because it is a diagonal matrix, so inversion is 1 upon that. Original matrix is AT square minus 1, so it will be inverted. So you can do this. What is determinant of this? I can calculate determinant of this, right? So you know that determinant of original matrix, not this metric, original matrix of not this. So that is this. And then his symbol, he also gave you symbol definition. Christopher symbol diya tha na first day. Yes. I'm trying to do what was done in the first class. So he calculated Christopher symbol, he gave very complicated formula, and also he did some calculation for Christopher symbol. But you don't have to do anything. It's only matter of second. The command is what? CHR. And the commands are very friendly. Determinant is DTG, Christopher symbol is CHR, Riemann is REIM, Riemann. So Ricky is RIC. So it's all friendly, very friendly. And it is almost instant. So many components, but it is almost instant. And 0.016 second. But maple and this other is more fast. Then I will calculate Riemann tensor, R, A, B, C, D. So A is up, B, C, D is down. You can calculate any quantity you like. This is just to demonstrate, right? So R up, B, C, D down. So R up, B, C, D down. All down, down, down. One is up, all three down. So this can be calculated. And then also is almost instant, right? So it is...
CD stand for?
Huh? What CD? Oh, display. Calculate and display. See, there is GR calc for calculation, GR display for display, GR transform for changing, metric transformation, alter for simply changing and simplifying. So, one command calc D will calculate and display both.
A booklet hai. Booklet
hai. I can give you now PDF file if you want. PDF file can be given for manual because printing is not possible now.
Mm-hmm.
So, mail kar dete. Sabko manual mail kar deta hu GR tensor ka for everyone. Because it can calculate some like Raichaudhuri equation directly. Raichaudhuri equation is a very complicated thing, but it can calculate in one command, Raichaudhuri equation. If you heard of Raichaudhuri equation, you know it is very complicated. So it can do in very straight way. All right. Then Ricky scalar. This is a Ricky tensor. Ricky tensor, RAB up down, and then Ricky scalar is further contraction. Contraction of Ricky tensor is Ricky scalar, which can be calculated like this. So, this is first Ricky scalar RA, RA, right. Then you have another Ricky scalar RAB, RAB. So, that is second RAB, RAB. This is the Ricky squared. That is Ricky scalar, this is Ricky squared scalar. So, that is RAB. And then you have Riemann scalar. So, that is the squared of the Riemann curvature. So, this is Ricky scalar and then it can be calculated very easily. Right. Then G up down. That is what is this. All right. Then simplification, all this simplification is here, you can see. Either you can give 1 or you can give simplify. Simplify trigonometric, you can write 2 or trigonometric. 3 is for power, 4 for hypergeometric, 5 for simplification, 6 for expand, 7 for factor and so on. So, this is the list. Right?
Is it the menu, no?
No, menu. You can give this command. You can give command to select name. Right? So that will be this. All right. So I have calculated this. Is a what we are trying to do is we are trying to play with this. So we have now. Simplify display. Up, down, 1, 1. Suppose this is a, that one is a matrix, 4 by 4 matrix. Suppose you need one component. Most of the time you need any component. So, I can take any 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, whatever component. Right? So, 0, 1, 2, 3, whatever component. TT, you can write instead of 1, you can write what is RR or TT or whatever you like. Right? Now, this is the first component because here it is like this. So, this is actually RR component. 1, 1 is RR, 0, 0 is TT, right. So, I am trying to extract 1, 1 components and that is what is this. And I can call it R 1, 1 because if I need to use it again in the future, I must save it. Save it as a variable. So, I have saved in a variable R 1, 1 and it is like this, right. I can simplify that factor. This is factor. You can put a scale factor, A is equal to 2 by 3. What it represent? A is equal to 2, T to the power 2 by 3. Tumne pad liya na pura course? Kya Rahul? What is T to the power 2 by 3?
Radiation.
So, I can put substitute solution and then I can analyze this. Right? So, this is, but I'll tell you how to calculate solution also. So, that's there. And R11 will be calculated and then you substitute this and that all solution. So, there is a solution. All right. Iske baad thoda sa complicated hai programming, which I don't want to show at first place. I don't want to do because today everything, this is a bit complicated. I will do something I want to do which is important for everyone. Many people want that. Yeah. So, let me take another one. I'll come with the same one, Robertson-Walker only. I'll take the Robertson-Walker only. right? Any question? ठीक है, फर्स्ट लेक्चर के सब चीज़ हमने कर दिया. उन्होंने जो फर्स्ट लेक्चर में रॉबर्टसन वगैरह के बारे में वट एवर कैलकुलेशन ही डिड एंड सम एडिशनल कैलकुलेशन हैज़ बीन डन. एनी क्वेश्चन? और कुछ है? नाउ लेट्स टेक अनदर थिंग, डिफाइनिंग न्यू क्वांटिटीज, डिफाइनिंग एनर्जी मोमेंटम टेंसर, विच इज मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल डू. देन आई नीड टू डिफाइन एनर्जी मोमेंटम टेंसर एंड ऑल दैट आई विल शो नाउ, बिकॉज दैट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन थिंग most of the people do. So I will again restart because this is what is. Restart because the previous one, otherwise it will interfere with the previous one. So again invoking GI tensor and loading RW. Robertson Walker in the, is it, I think, 1 minute, okay, let me see if it is same, yeah. So now I calculate up down, GR calc display up down. So that is what is the Einstein equation which was written here. So you have GAB is equal to K times TAB. So this will determine your field equation. That will determine the field equation, right? That is the field equation, and you want to do component wise. So that is what I am doing. Left hand side is very easy because you have already metric there, but now I will tell you how to create the right hand side also. So this is your up down, that GR tensor. I am using up down because up down is very easy. If I use down, there will be lot of trigonometric function involved, right? So I have done, this is for very simple calculation, G up down. If you use, let me make bit simple, smaller size so that more thing will be. Is it visible? No, it's okay. So it's right there. Now I can expand this because the denominator and all can be simplified. And then I'll expand this and this place. So that's there. And if you see here, there is one more thing which I used auto alias. Now what auto alias does, auto alias I have written. So it will not give DDT. Instead of DDT, it will give colon T or this T. And if it is R, it will give R, or if it is X. So auto alias if you do, there is an inbuilt function which converts DDT into this T, right? So derivative will be displayed very simple, in the simple way. And it will also take less memory. So better you use auto-alias. Auto-alias frequently used, specifically when you do in the use Stallman boundary. So this is the energy momentum tensor, right hand side. I am defining up, you can define down, whatever you like, it is fine, right? Because right. So this is the definition. Definition is rho, or you can mu, density plus pressure, mu. Ye toh bata diya sabko first lecture mein. I want to tell you how to calculate this and how to put in the computer. So you have to define four velocity you have to define u. So you can use two commands. I can you write in the vector form, or you can use directly use conical delta. Conical delta means, you know, so only T component. So I can use directly vector, or I can use directly this. So I have defined this, and then up I calculate it is there, and I can there. Now this is very important definition. This is most important definition because you will frequently require to define new tensors many times. This is simple thing, but it is, this is energy momentum tensor is a simple tensor. But if you talk about EGB, it becomes very, very complicated, like Lovelock becomes very complicated. But ultimately, Galilean he has showed is very complicated. But ultimately, equations are second order. But defining, you need to define properly. If you want to calculate yourself, it is very, very difficult task. It is, right? So I want to define, I have given you definition, syntax, and then I'll define this. So definition is right, it starts with single colon. And if you remember yesterday, I was giving double colon. That is for Java version. Here single colon, TAB in the curly bracket. Curly bracket is very important, otherwise it will not work. Mu, rho is a function of T, pressure is a function of T, UA, UB, P, T, GAB. So this is the definition. Any error will not take it further. It will stop here. So this is correct definition, so it is created. And then you can calculate curve. So that's the energy momentum tensor. You know that it is minus rho PPP, minus rho PPP. I can use T X Y Z, I can use R X Y Z T. Yeah, mera choice. But that is there, right? Any difficulty? Because this is very important. You will be defining many new tensor. You will be defining many new tensor yourself. And you need to do this, right? Most of the tensors are available. Like TAB cannot be there in the GR tensor. The left hand side, most of the tensor, whatever you need each other equation, you need any other norm, all are there. But TAB is not there. Suppose I want to define that equation, GAB plus lambda GAB. That is not there. I can write this two as a EAB, and I can define EAB as GAB plus lambda. So that Einstein equation will become modified Einstein equation, right? So many times required. When you talk about EGB or Galilean, you need additional term, R plus something. So there you need this thing. So that's why it is very important. Again, once again, auto alias. Now I will calculate divergence. Divergence of what? कौन सा कहाँ पे सेम है नहीं सेम कैसे रहेंगे हाउ कैन इट बी सेम ये अप डाउन है ना अप डाउन है नहीं इट कैन नॉट बी सेम सी इट इज नहीं 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 आप समझ नहीं रहे वंस आई डिफाइन टी अप अप और टी डाउन डाउन आई कैन कैलकुलेट एनी अदर थिंग मैंने टी अप अप डिफाइन किया आई कैन कैलकुलेट टी डाउन डाउन आई कैन कैलकुलेट टी अप डाउन ऐसे जरूरी नहीं कि कोई भी एक डिफाइन कर दीजिए बाकी ऑटोमेटिक बाकी तो कॉन्ट्रैक्शन और इसका सवाल है ना मैनिपुलेशन है आई हैव डिफाइंड अप अप बट आई कैन स्टिल कैलकुलेट अ डाउन डाउन आई कैन स्टिल कैलकुलेट डाउन डाउन बिकॉज इफ यू सी इन द डेफिनेशन इट इज ए बी दिस कैन बिकम अप डाउन दिस कैन बिकम एनी थिंग राइट दिस इज टी ए बी तो आई कैन डू Even if I calculate up down, this I have done down down, because if it is up down, then I have to write another thing. This is down down. Definition. Not redefined, man. One is text. The dark one is the text, and the red one is the command. Command is red one. I didn't redefine anything. Redefine is not there. The dark one. Is for your text to understand what I'm going to do next, and the red one is the actual command which I'm giving.
So red one is the input and blue one is output.
Blue one is output, but black one is for understanding. The black one is for text. Otherwise, if I just go on writing it, nothing will be clear. Is it clear? So I'm calculating. Ah, bolo. नहीं तो क्या हाउ कंप्यूटर विल नो इफ यू डोंट राइट म्यू टी इट विल टेक इट एज अ कॉन्स्टेंट तो यू हैव टू राइट दैट यू हैव टू राइट दिस टी अदरवाइज इट विल टेक कॉन्स्टेंट नेक्स्ट मोस्ट ऑफ द इक्वेशन मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यू रिक्वायर व्हाट कंजर्वेशन equation or divergence of energy momentum tensor. Next I will calculate divergence. So I will define what is divergence. Right? Divergence is defined as up up. Dekho abhi up up le liya. Because it is there. Down down is there. So up up it will automatically take. So this is hat is for up up. So J up, T A B up, do up hai aur ek down hai. So we will be left with one up. Right? this is the definition TAB down. So, it will be left with what? Only JA, J up, correct? Three index hai, do BB to idhar ho gaya, to only one index is there, A. So, I want to take divergence of that. So, that will be divergence and then I can calculate this. This is your, what is this equation called? Ye kya bolte hai isko? Divergence equation ko kya bolte hai? Continuity. Equal to 0 karna padega, that will become this.
So,
यहाँ define किया ना, ऊपर ही है, वहीं पे J, T A B divergence, that is there. All right, so that is I can again auto alias and it becomes more simple, which you will see in the notebook, papers also. So this is the form equal to zero, right? That is what is happening. All right. Any doubt? All right. So this is what is the this. Now next I'll calculate what is Einstein equation. Einstein equation, ये तो हो गया. Einstein equation is defined here, which I have written there also. So GAB is equal to kappa times TAB. आपको हाथ से कुछ calculate ही नहीं करना. Now you have left hand side, you have right hand side. You can again ask computer to calculate Einstein equation. So here I define Einstein equation up down. A is up now down, because previous case I showed you how to calculate down, but you can also have up. So yahan pe up ho jayega. You have to make sure the index are properly matched. Up down. So A up hai aur B down hai. Very beautiful is that this you can keep this equal to. Because if I write minus, then it is again my handwork. So I have left hand side and right hand side. So I can, in GR define, I can leave that equal to sign. I don't have to write minus equal to 0 or minus or something. I can do that, right? So that is what is the Einstein equation, and then expand it, and that's how you get Einstein equation all. And here you can make it LaTeX also. LaTeX command is there. If you LaTeX, then it will become LaTeX. So that is the Einstein equation, which takes some time to calculate. Right, so this is Einstein Robertson Walker metric, and then you have a Einstein equation, expand and display. That's your anything else? Samajh mein aa gaya? I can solve also it, we can solve also. और बोलो हो गया आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन और व्हाट एल्स
नीड सम टाइम फॉर
प्रैक्टिस ना जरूरत नहीं है इट डजंट नीड मच टाइम व्हाट यू नीड इज दिस वर्कशीट व्हिच आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू यू डोंट हैव टू वरी
बहुत काम आसान हो गया
सर वेरी इजी वेरी वेरी इजी In fact, you can find solution. After that, you can find solution also. Because I don't know under what condition, because this is all done. So you need to find new solution, and then everything becomes very, very trivial. Very, very trivial. Right? Let me show you some complicated equation also. It's very simple here. Things Robertson Walker to simple, na? It's a very simple thing. Let me tell you Tolman Bondi. You know Tolman Bondi? Anybody knows? No. It's a gravitational collapse. See, you didn't allow me to bring that Mach 1. Otherwise, you know Oppenheimer-Snyder model? Gravitational collapse, kisne suna? Suna nahi kya? Madam ne suna bas, aur kisi ne nahi. So, there is a Oppenheimer-Snyder model, 39 model, matching condition. You have to match. You can match Robertson Walker with the exterior. As I said, in the Birkhoff theorem, Schwarzschild metric, any spherically symmetric object, massive object, the exterior is what? Schwarzschild. But you have to prove it, you have to match it. So you can show that you can match this to space-time. Take it, na? Inside is Robertson Walker, outside is Schwarzschild, you can match, smoothly match. And gravitational collapse is that, right? So interior is Robertson Walker, exterior is Schwarzschild. When you make collapse, it becomes black hole. Right? That becomes black hole. So that is very important, very, very important model. Entire matching condition, which requires a lot of calculation, can be done using GR tensor. GR tensor means pura matching condition. Right? So because you are, these days you want to do in modified gravitational collapse, and lot of papers on the gravitational collapse, and also lot of paper in Birkhoff theorem, right? So if, for example, modified gravity like massive gravity or FR gravity doesn't obey Birkhoff theorem. It doesn't obey Birkhoff theorem. So if you try to run that in FR gravity, it will not work. So this is easy to check, otherwise it's very, very complicated. It's a person like Ganeshji does with help, with the hand I can't. ठीक है ही डज मोस्ट ऑफ द कैलकुलेशन बाय हैंड हाँ हैंड अभी भी हैंड से करता हूँ ही इज़ वेरी वेरी कॉम्पिटेंट और ही राइट्स हिज ओन कमांड ओन प्रोग्रामिंग बिकॉज ही वॉज सो फॉर पोस्ट डॉक मोस्ट ऑफ एंड नाउ इज इन जॉब सो इज फेसिंग नाउ प्रॉब्लम्स अदरवाइज ही वॉज फुल टाइम रिसर्चर तो ही विल ऑलवेज यूज हैंड टू कैलकुलेट एनीथिंग लेट मी शो यू सम सिंपल मोर complicated one or two. I have few minutes. I'll just give me one complicated equation. I'll just show Tolman-Bondi. That is my favorite thing because that is my favorite because I worked lot in the Tolman-Bondi before, not now. I also worked in lot in this Vaidya solution which I wanted to show, but I'll show you Tolman-Bondi, which is my famous. It is generalization of Robertson Walker. It is exactly the Robertson Walker, but it is inhomogeneous, not homogeneous. You have only here t variable, a is function, scale factor is a function of t only, here function of rt. So let's take, this is very important, and I have generalized this to does to D sitter case also, right? So this is Q load dust, and I have lot of constraint here. I tell you everything. So if you see here, it looks like exactly Robertson Walker. You can take FR to be equal to minus one or something. This can be taken as zero. FR is equal to zero. That correspond to marginally bound. Then it is exactly Robertson Walker. A is replaced by capital R. R is a function of T and R. Now, why this constraint? Why I am writing this constraint? Because there are derivatives here. There are so many derivatives, right? So, second order derivative, you can write in the first order derivative. And computer can handle first order better than second order, right? So, this is like second order derivative can be written in terms of no derivative. This is first order derivatives can be written as no derivative, right? This is second order mixed derivative can be written in terms of first order derivative. This is third order derivative can be written in first order derivative. So computer can easily handle these constraints, but provided that constraint can be added at the time of make g, when you make g, you can add constraint also. You can add constraint. It is very easy to enter. So this is one of the most complicated apart from Kerr. Kerr is a rotating black hole, which is very complicated. So this is gravitational, Robertson Walker is also for dust. You can have different universe, but this is dust solution. It is solution of Einstein equation for dust as a source. So this is taken as standard model for inhomogeneous cosmology. It's a modification of Robertson Walker. Let me calculate G up down. It is a solution. It is a solution of Einstein equation. GAB is equal to TAB. And where TAB is only what? Rho 0, 0. Now I gave you perfect fluid. Rho PPP minus rho PPP. So there is only minus rho, which is function of RT. So when you calculate Einstein equation, it should satisfy and it should give me only rho. Right? Let's see. So that's GR calc, and then I'll simplify. Now what is 12.1 here is very important. 12.1 is very important. Right, 12 is simplify and 1 is applying constraint. So what I am trying to do, when I calculate GR up down, it generates lot of third order and second order derivatives. The third order, second order derivatives can be converted using this constraint into first order, and then the things will become very simple. So that's what I'm doing here. So 12 is simplification, 1 is apply constraint, right? So this is G down, and then I apply constraint, and it is there, and auto alias, if I don't use, I'll get in terms of TT, you'll see TT. So as I said, you'll get only rho, only this 0,0 component, because it is a solution of Einstein equation. The equations were horrible, constraints were horrible, but GI tensor can handle very easily. And it can convert into first order equation, and this is what. But when you apply auto alias, it will become more simple, simplified form. No del and no d, nothing. So it will become a RT. Right? I can calculate Riemann squared, RABCD, which is takes at least a month to calculate for Tolman body. So I have calculated, and now I'll apply simplification and also constraint, and it becomes very simple. That's very simple. It has a singularity at r is equal to 0, and also at r dash is equal to 0. The r is equal to 0 is called self-focusing singularity. R dash is equal to 0 is called self-crossing singularity, right? Then if I want to calculate wild tensor and all, then I have to invoke library. This I didn't tell you. There are sometimes, if you calculate directly this, you will see it will give error. So it requires this library. So what you have to do, read lib. You have to invoke the library, and then it is there. All right. So that gives me calculation, and what is CMB is all scalar associated with Ricci. So it will calculate all scalars, and it will display. So display all the scalar associated with what? Ricci. And you can also calculate scalars associated with Weyl tensor. Ricci tensor, Weyl tensor, all this tensor associated with this, you can. All right. So that is what is the complicated calculation.
So once you define your metric, you can straightforward go to Einstein equation also, no?
Yeah.
There is no need to be stepwise or something like that.
No, this is for demonstration.
Yeah.
That is for demonstration. And finally, I'll go give me famous with their solution, and also as Gauss-Bonnet. This is last. Oh, no, this will be very complicated. Yeah. This is my last slide. Did I define? Yeah. That's fine. Let's see if it works properly. EGB kar leta sirf ek bhi nahi. This is a bit complicated now. All right. EGB ka wala EGB ka nahi hai na. और भी होगा आई जस्ट वांट टू शो Gauss-Bonnet ही हैज शोन यू Gauss-Bonnet देन आपको Gauss-Bonnet बताया ना आई विल शो यू Gauss-Bonnet वर्कशीट ईजीबी कौन सा दिखाए और इस भी Gauss-Bonnet विद दया आई विल शो यू दिस या दैट्स राइट Gauss-Bonnet बताया ना Gauss-Bonnet को बताते हैं आपको राइट सो Gauss-Bonnet यू कैन डू इन फोर डायमेंशन बट ओनली कपल टू स्केलर फील्ड बट इट इज नॉर्मली इन द फाइव डायमेंशन सो व्हाट हैपन्स इन एक्शन व्हाट हैपन्स आई शो यू So in the action you have r plus square terms. यहाँ पे square terms रहेंगे. तो basically it is r square alpha times r square minus r a b 4 RAB, RAB, RAB and plus RABCD, RABCD. That's what, right? So minus G and D for you, no. I'm not writing that. Minus G and D. So the equation becomes very complicated. When you vary this equation, it becomes very, very complicated. But still it is second order. To see this, you need at least 5 dimension. You need to have 5 dimension. So you can vary this equation and you will arrive with modified equation, which is called this. So you'll get an equation which is GAB plus alpha HAB is equal to TAB. KK I can write, right? So this will be the equation. This will be the modified equation, where HAB is the Lankos tensor, right? Lankos tensor, which R will generate this one, and that additional square term will generate this, right? So I want to do this, and I'm trying to find Vedya solution in EGB gravity, right? So that is what is this, very simple. Make EGB, EGB is 5 dimension, so you have, I'll enter line element and there is this Vedya metric. So we have V in Vedya metric, instead of T we use V, R, theta, phi, psi. There are 5 coordinates now, V, R, theta, phi, psi. And there is only one variable, only one function, F of V, R, which is to be calculated. So this is what is this. Right, so metric is created and I have only one function, FVR. But Vedya solution is not spherically diagonal, it has off diagonal term. You can see this is off diagonal, very important.
5 by 5.
Yeah, 5 by 5. All right. Now energy momentum tensor I'm taking as a very complicated charge because I want to show you how to define charge also. Right, so this is your A, this is your FAB is a field, Maxwell field, A is your potential. So that is what is this, your definition. Aapne charge ke saath bataya ki unhone kuch? Did he tell? No charge. Charge nahi bataya. So, but you know Einstein Maxwell equation you have to solve. And FAB is a Maxwell field. And A is your vector. So that's what I'm trying to calculate. So don't worry about this. This is a very simple thing. Now, energy momentum tensor of EGB is very, Vedya is a very different kind of metric. It is not normal thing. Vedya, aapne star dekha honga in the night, star, if you see any light, to uske, I'll show you in this diagram. This is a star, but you can see it radiates like this. It will look like this. Ab koi bhi light ko dekhenge night mein, it will be like this. Star also look like this. So Vedya solution is solution of this part, this region. This is interior. Here it is Schwarzschild. This is interior. We don't know. This region is called Vedya solution. So it is the radiating metric, right? And if you reverse it, it will collapse. It will also collapse. So ye direction jo hai, ye null hai. Null vector say, perpendicular vector say. So they are null vector. So it is solution of that. And that you can do here. That's why you have to define null vector. Null vectors are this. This is a null vector. So it is 1 0 0, 1 0 0. Right? And then your energy momentum tensor is dust, radiation or null dust plus charge. So this is the complicated charge energy momentum tensor. This part is totally charge. Ye charge ka definition hai. Theek hai? So it was not unfortunately taught to you. Charge ka energy, that I showed you perfect fluid energy momentum tensor. This is energy momentum of charge and that is for dust. Dust I showed you in the first case. So if your pressure is zero, it is dust. So you get a mu. Rho, mu, but वहाँ पे mu t use किया था मैंने mu t u a u b, but these are null vectors, so it is l a l b, psi, right? So that is what is this. So this is complicated energy momentum tensor, एंड एफ ए बी जो है, एफ ए बी यहाँ पे डिफाइन कर दिया हमने, जो एफ ए बी है दैट इज डिफाइंड हियर. ठीक है, सो ऑल नीड टू बी डिफाइंड, एफ ए बी इज डिफाइंड. आई एम यूजिंग दिस डेफिनेशन फर्दर एंड आई एम ट्राइंग टू गिव यू दिस. सो लाइक दिस एंड देन यू कैलकुलेट दिस. सो दिस इज ए एनर्जी मोमेंटम टेंसर ऑफ चार्ज एंड देन यू कैन कैलकुलेट एंटायर एनर्जी मोमेंटम टेंसर, तो यू विल गेट दिस. तो इट हैज वन ऑफ डायगोनल एलिमेंट, यू कैन सी वन ऑफ डायगोनल एलिमेंट. तो ये हो गया तुम्हारा नॉर्मल, आपका डायगोनल रहता है स्फेरिकली सिमेट्रिक, बट यू हैव नाउ वैद्या सॉल्यूशन, तो यू विल गेट वन ऑफ डायगोनल. इट इज सेम एज दिस, सेम एज दिस. ठीक है, फर्स्ट टू चार्ज के माइनस माइनस होते हैं, नेक्स्ट टू इज प्लस प्लस. तो इन केस ऑफ फोर डायमेंशन द ट्रेस इज जीरो, बट इन फाइव डायमेंशन नो ट्रेस जीरो. सो चार्ज इन फाइव डायमेंशन इज बिट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, इट्स वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट थिंग. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू डिफाइन दैट एच ए बी, एच ए बी विच इज कॉल्ड लैंक्वस टेंसर विच इज दिस एल जी बी. वो जो एच ए बी बोला ना, दैट इज हियर, दिस इज योर एच ए बी, राइट, एल जी बी, राइट. सो दिस इज वॉट इज डिफाइंड, दिस इज योर रिकी स्केलर एंड आई कैन डिफाइन दिस एज दिस एंड देयरफॉर योर मॉडिफाइड इक्वेशन. ये तुम्हारा ये हो गया, वो जो फर्स्ट इक्वेशन में मैंने लिखा आर स्क्वायर, आर स्क्वायर फोर आर ए बी, आर ए बी एंड देन आर ए बी सी डी, आर ए बी सी डी एंड दिस इज योर एच ए डी बी. तो योर मॉडिफाइड आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन इज दिस, दिस इज योर जी आर पार्ट, दिस इज योर जी आर पार्ट एंड देन प्लस अल्फा टाइम्स योर एच ए बी. द एच ए बी इज वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, दिस इज वॉट वॉज शोन टू यू यस्टरडे. ठीक है, तो ये कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है, बट यू नीड टू डिफाइन न्यू टेंसर ऑलवेज. तो आई हैव डिफाइंड दिस न्यू टेंसर, बट यू विल सी दैट द रिजल्टेंट आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन इज स्टिल सेकेंड ऑर्डर, वेरी वेरी सिंपल. सो दैट आई हैव कैलकुलेटेड. सो योर गॉस बोने अप डाउन, नाउ आई विल कैलकुलेट गॉस बोने अप डाउन, यू विल सी दैट इज सेकेंड ऑर्डर इक्वेशन अगेन. एंड व्हेन यू टेक अल्फा इज इक्वल टू जीरो, इट विल बिकम आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन, आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन, राइट. So I have defined your left hand side, which is energy momentum tensor of a charge fluid, and then the left hand side is my Gauss Bonnet. I'll write Einstein equation, field equation I have written, field equation Gauss Bonnet AB is equal to TAB. So in another definition, first I have defined Gauss Bonnet, then is another definition. So you have to go on defining whatever you require. So defined, and then I will calculate field equation. It will give me field equation. It looks complicated. Very complicated, but the equations are second order. And the first equation is only first order. VV equation is only first order. So what I'll do? I'll take field equation VV component. Dekhiye, field equation ko le liya VV component. And then I solve it. Equal to, right? So it will with because it has charge. Right hand side is your C charge. Charge is there. So this equation, this is the field equation. Field equation. Most simple equation in case of Gauss Bonnet, and that can be solved very easily. It will take bit time, but it will be solved. That is the solution of black hole in Einstein Gauss Bonnet gravity. Right? And you can simplify. Later on, I have done some simplification, but this is the solution.
You can also take
a
root if you.
No, root nahi niklega. Root. Now, alpha you can take out and take in. So, most of the books or papers give this format. So, I have separated it. You can see, I can simplify this. 1 plus minus r square by 4 alpha plus under root of whatever. 1 plus 8 mv alpha upon here. So, that is what is this equation. Iske baad thoda sa haath se likh sakte to likh se. Ye bhi jarurat nahi, ye bhi simplify ho jata actually chahe to. That also can be simplified. So this is a black hole in EGB, and this is our paper published in Physical Relativity, which is the calculation which I have shown you in 2004. So long ago, but this is published paper. But all calculation which we do is here only. Any complicated Galilean or whatever, it is possible. Any question? Thank you so much. If you have any question, you are free to ask.